Street children in Lira move around looking for old plastic bottles, scrap metals, and old car tires to sell to earn a living. Now, Stephen Nono Odongo, a 28-year-old former street child, has come up with an initiative to train street children in carpentry so they can earn a living, though he is lacking enough resources.
Because right now, if you see the kids, I'm trying to train them. They are street kids, which right now, they sometimes I got challenged. I want also to get some skills, but sometimes I find it very hard for me to skill them because the money I get here is very small.
According to Nono, his hopes were raised when he met the former Speaker of Parliament, the late Jacob Olanya, who pledged to help him out. However, his hopes faded when he got the sad news of the death of the late Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya.
Honorable, the late right now, that was 2020, around, so he was like promising us, he made us to be first become happy. He was very happy with us, he was showing us love, he welcomed us like we are sons which one time left home. So he welcomed us, he was very happy with us. And even right now, I'm very sorry to say, my God, rest his soul.
Nono revealed over 250 youth go to his workshop for training. He has called on the government and well-wishers to help skill the youth in the ghettos.
Appeal to the government, the well-wishers, the NGOs. I would like, if possible, they would also take the chance to visit the ghetto and also reach them. Because right now, if I'm to say, the number of children that always come to me, they want to get skilled up, they want to learn, they want to know things which helps them in life.
A short distance away from Nono's workshop, there's another workshop where youth make different items from old tires. They sell, they say, nothing from a tire is useless. They make bicycle brakes, parts of machines, sandals, and rubber for tying luggages. Tony Okwi, the Kak Attack Ghetto Ambassador, explains the different things made from old tires. He appeals to government for support.
We make this, we cut this old thing from the old tires. We make it for making the Lugambire and for making the Olokoba.
Matai Obero, the chairperson of Ghetto Youth, says he's struggling to ensure that street children live a decent life.
We still have chance to do anything if you call us. Still struggling with these street children. The reason I'm fighting for the future of these young kids.
Recently, street children organized themselves and swept the mayor's garden. Nicholas Obutu, the ghetto ambassador Lango Seb County, who is also a former street child, says this was done to show people that street children can also go in society.
Within the community. So we still need to show that, you know, cleaning town and like cleaning around Alira main market is just harmony, you know. It's just trying to withdraw people's attention to it. Okay, we are sorry, but we can also do it better.
It's the attitude that most people have towards these people. There are some of these people who are bad and there are some of them who are good. So most of the people just thinks that these people are bad. And
Lawrence Egole, the Lira resident city commissioner, says most street children in Lira were born during insurgency and abandoned by their parents.
This is a problem everywhere in major cities. We have them a lot. And you know, ours is a little bit unique. You will recall that in the last over two decades, we had these insurgencies where a lot of parents abandoned their children. There were children who were produced out of wedlock. They don't know who their parents are and they end up on the streets. So ours become a little bit unique because a lot of those children were produced during these insurgencies where parents, some parents cannot look after their children.
Report by Hudson Apunyu for the news.